This is the first of a 5 video series where we're going to be creating this animation from scratch inside After Effects using surprisingly simple techniques and exploring the new features that After Effects has to make our workflow even more efficient. This video is proudly brought to you with the help of Adobe. The other videos in this series are already available on the Adobe Video and Motion channel on their Essential Workflow playlist, linked up here and down in the description as well, so you don't have to wait at all. In this video, we'll be creating this animation using the new Properties panel in After Effects, which will serve as the essential foundation for all of the other instances and neat effects that will just be the icing on top. This whole scene is created essentially by animating one shape and then creatively looping and duplicating it to get the illusion of some sort of jellyfish-like ocean creature. Now, I'm using the beta version of After Effects, which at the time of recording is where you can access the new Properties panel, but it will be added to the next version of After Effects in early 2022. Until then, you can download the beta from the Creative Cloud app, select Beta Apps, and then install the freshest version of After Effects alongside the current release. So we're going to be using the Properties panel, which is exactly like the Properties panel in other Adobe applications. This is all the properties of the layer that you've got selected. Here we've got a square on a shape layer. Previously, we would have had to toggle down all of these in the timeline to get to these settings. And while we're here, a handy shortcut to know to open all of these at once is to hold Ctrl or Command, click this once, and it will open everything. But that kind of makes your timeline really difficult to use because all of the space is taken up by just one layer. So it's much easier to just select your layer and then adjust its roundness and other properties up here in the Properties panel without having to change the view of your timeline and interrupting your flow as you're animating down here. So let's delete this and create it from scratch. So with the rectangle tool selected, we're going to click and drag holding the shift key to keep it square. Now it doesn't need to be in the exact middle. We can open up the align panel and align it to the composition horizontally and vertically. And we can see in the Properties panel that its size is a pretty arbitrary number. Let's change that down to 50, so it's much smaller. And we're going to animate 3 properties of this square: its position, its size, and its roundness. In our final version, our square is essentially going to be bouncing up and down and turning into a circle as it moves upwards. And let's start with our square a bit away from the center because we don't want them all meeting in the middle once they're duplicated. So let's move its Y position up to around about 320 there. And let's keyframe its position here. And then about half a second later, which in this case is 12 frames, let's move its position even further up, around about 100 pixels. Now let's select those keyframes and easy ease them with F9, so that motion is a bit smoother. There. Now we do want this to bounce back down and loop. And we can do that with a very simple expression. So let's hold Alt or Option and click the stopwatch here and type loop out, and then in parentheses type ping pong. And what that does is loop these keyframes by bouncing between them. So we get a nice bouncing square going up and down. And because these keyframes are half a second apart, we get a perfect 1 second loop. And if we want it to bounce higher, we can change this state to a higher position, and we've got a larger bounce now. Now by using a looping expression like this, and later by using pre-comps, we make this animation really adjustable. So we can add all of our effects, get up to the final render, and if we want to change anything to this base animation, we can do that very easily with a simple adjustment of just these 2 keyframes. Very useful in a professional workflow where client changes come in often. Now let's adjust its size. We'll keyframe it here, and then at that half second mark, let's make it larger, maybe up to 150. And easy ease those keyframes too. And we want this to loop also. So a very easy way to do that is to select our position property, which already has that expression, right click, choose copy expression only, select the size property, and paste it with Control V. So now we've got the size looping too as it bounces. Now to turn it into a circle, we can do that with its roundness property. So let's keyframe it at 0 here, and then at 12 frames in, let's increase it to 75, which will make it a perfect circle. Then let's easy ease again and paste on our looping expression, and there we go. Now I want to animate one more property, one that is going to mimic a squid or cuttlefish changing color, which they do by expanding these pigmented pouches called chromatophores. And we can mimic that using the stroke of this shape. At the moment, we've got a 10-point stroke, but let's animate that property. Let's keep it at 10 points when it's at its largest point, where it's a circle. Keyframe its stroke width here. And then at the starting frame, when it's a small square, let's increase that way up to about 30. Again, easy ease and paste our expression. And now we've got this nice breathing quality to the animation. It looks very organic, almost like a muscle contracting. And because the yellow is more prominent at this state, it looks like it's changing color, just not completely. But in the animation, there's only one frame where we do get these sharp corners, and that's a little jarring. So to remove that, let's just change the roundness from 0 at the start here up to 1. So now it's much smoother. And to amplify that breathing motion, we can make an adjustment to the motion curve in the graph editor. So let's select all of our keyframes, head into the graph editor, and in the speed graph, select them all and drag both of these handles inwards to create a higher point of acceleration in the middle so that there's more easing. And there our breathing animation is more intense and our main animation is completed. In the next video, linked right up here, we're gonna use a bunch of pre-comping tricks to turn this one shape into our completed abstract sea creature and get closer to our final result.